I looked up saying it was a Zembra or Barbara or whatever it's called. So you know what I'm saying, right? I don't. Alright, so he said that other side was a needling seat. It's not. This is the needling seat side. So it didn't hold. So yeah. And this carburetor is not totally not working, but knowing that I use the opposite side, this says this needling seat is not working. As I pressurized that side and that side worked. Why would it hold pressure? I don't know. But this side didn't. You can refer back to the video where I didn't know what I was doing. I was doing it. Okay. So let's pull this guy up out of here. Springs out. Needles right there. Somewhere. And it's got a rubber tip on it. Doesn't seem to be that hard. Again, I can't see down inside of here. Inside the thing, and all I have is this bright light, so you can bear with me. I do not see anything down in there. I do not see nothing down there, guys. And the tip doesn't seem to be hard. What are you talking about? It's soft. Soft rubber. So the fuels hasn't affected it. So the only other thing you can say is that this little arm that adjusts against the pumper, is tweaked. It's tweaked. You know what I mean by tweaked. See if we can get this guy back in here where it's supposed to be at. Well, let's loosen the old springaroo. Which I probably will, though. Yeah. Probably worked from this side, right? You guys are still in the picture. Still in the shots. I just tuned in. I'm trying to get this little spring located back in its location, and then try to get the old what am I trying to say? Know what I'm trying to say? Back in the location. And it's quite the workout to get that back in there. Imagine without new glasses. I don't have my little tiny screwdrivers anymore. You say, what are you doing? Lost them. Put them down where I used them at and forgot. lessen up that little set screw just a smidge more. Maybe I can slide her underneath there. Maybe. Probably not though. Oh no. We got it, guys. Got her. I don't know how I did it. Okay. Alright, so... yeah, gonna have to get that thing back out. It looks like it's right though. I don't know how it didn't. How didn't it? What are you saying? What are you trying to say? I'm trying to say, how would it not hold the pressure when I was trying it? That's what I'm trying to say. Why wasn't it holding the pressure? The pressure. Yeah. Hang on, I gotta hook up the power to the camera and find that pop-off thing that I just put away. So, I need to get the pop-out thing back out. Because I don't understand why. But I didn't know what I was doing, and I tried putting pressure in this guy. And it didn't hold. Thing. Why did that do what it did? You said, what it do? What it do? Well, let's see. Borrow that primer bob hose. Hook it up on the end of this guy. And hook it up on this, which is the wrong side. Let's see. Try again. Yeah, see, she's not seating. The needle seat is not seating. Push down on it. Let's see. Oh. Looks like me, you gotta put this carburetor all back together to see if she's gonna hold. You dummy. Alright. You dummy. It's ways to go. Alright. Anybody know how this goes on? It goes that direction, it looks like. I think. Yes, do. Yeah. I don't know which way this guy goes, though. One of these ways, there it is. Dangerous. kind of important to pay attention when you're taking something apart if you want to put it back together. Of course, I just said not too long ago that just watch your videos. Yeah. Let's see. Let's see. Yeah, see, she don't hold. She used to hold some pressure, guys. I think it's my hose. My hose is no good? No? What do you think? Must be something wrong with this diaphragm here that it's a definite problem. Why? You know what I'm saying? Now, the question being is that all that's wrong with this carburetor? That little hole right there is the one that makes it work. With the needle in the seat, you can't tell if she's closing all the way until you get a new diaphragm on this carburetor. Now, the question being is, how much is a new carburetor versus another kit for this? I don't know. Maybe it's just as much. You know what I'm saying? Maybe just as much. Zamar. Well, let me look that up. I don't see no holes in it, but so it has to be the way it goes, because but that little hole's not a problem. Right there, that's just a dead end hole, and that shows where you line up your bolt holes. So this guy has to be leaking off, and you can't tell. You must have a hole there somewhere, so I don't see. All right, so we're gonna try to put a carburetor kit in this, or see what the price of a carburetor costs, and then we're going to go back to crank seals. You know how much a carburetor costs, really, but you know what I'm saying? All the information is right here by the handle, I think. Unless this is all emission stuff, which it could be. See, this one here is 2015 EPA California. So, what size is it? I don't know. It's a 2015 saw. There's a SKU number here. And like I said, it's 2015. They see a plant number. They show a plant number. Oh, it's a 40. It's a 42cc engine family. 42cc engine. Yeah, you might need that too. 42cc engine. Bring it down so I can get that shot for you. So you can get that in case your sticker's missing and you have a saw just like this. I'll put the screwdriver right where it's at, right at the end of it. Can you see how I did the screwdriver deal? Right there. Family. Okay? 42cc engine. Big one. Big one. Alright, let me check into the carburetor or the kit. And I'll have to bring it back on the next step of the saw deal.